Welcome to all of you. In this video, we will know about the comedy of manners. So, comedy is usually divided into higher comedy and lower comedy. Low comedy concerns itself directly or indirectly with manners. The Alchemist of Johnson busies itself directly with manners by means of characters varying from types of a single aspect of well-individualized figures. Comedy of intrigue centers around a love story but indirectly paints manners through characterization. The Shoemaker's Holiday and Fletcher's The Wild Goose Chase are examples of these varieties. As against this, the high comedy deals in thoughtful laughter. As George Meredith has pointed out in his masterly essay on comedy, Much Ado About Nothing is an example of high comedy. In it, we laugh when from moment to moment we contrast Benedict and Beatrice as they see themselves and as we see them. During the Restoration period, dramatic literature took a new form after the lapse of 20 years. In 1642, the theatres were closed, and the period that follows till the Restoration period was one of the barrenest in the history of drama. Drama was revived with a new vigor during the Restoration period. The dramatists of this age did not look back to the Elizabethan age or for inspiration or guidance. There was a complete break from the Elizabethan tradition in drama. The Restoration dramatists had neither love nor liking for Elizabethan comedy and tragedy. The dramatists of the period turned for inspiration and guidance to French dramatists with whose works they had become familiar. Pascal, Bossuet, Tenelon, Malherbe, Corneille, Racine, Molière, the great French dramatist, became the leaders and inspirers of Restoration drama. In September 1642, an ordinance was issued by the Puritan government of Britain, commanding the closing of the theatres and total suppression of stage players. A long and brilliant chapter of drama came to an abrupt and dismal end. But during the Commonwealth, occasional performances were combined at some times in noblemen's houses, where the nobility and gentry meet, but in no great numbers at others. In seasons and festivals such as Christmas or Bartholomew Fair, even at the old place houses at Whitehall, immunity against arrest and safety from rough handling for auditor and actor were not to be assured. By 1672, new theatres were opened, catering to the demands of the period. They were well equipped with suitable devices for spectacular effects with changeable scenery and stage machines. Under Charles I, their development of closer connection between theatre and the court. There was great demand for tragic comedies, of which Beaumont and Fletcher were the masters. In fact, the theatre was not only a place to witness a show, but also a place for display of beauty, of jewels and of decent dress. It also served as meeting place for formal social intercourse. In a debased form of galleries of certain famous music halls and playhouses were recognized, knew each other and also the actors. Total number of the audience remained in the range of 500. Most of the spectators belonged to the higher class of the society. Ladies also attended in bizarre masks. Bewicks often chatted with their friends while paying little attention to the play. The most attractive addition to the Restoration Theatre was introduction of actresses to perform female roles. In the former years, all the players were men or boys. Charles II had seen several performances by women during his exile abroad. He was famous for visiting theatres. He decided to introduce actresses. A woman first appeared on English stage to speak prologue to Othello and play the part of Desdemona. By and by, the number of actresses increased and they were a new attraction in themselves. They were pretty and vivacious, and it became the fashion for courtiers to try to make them their mistresses. The two most distinctive forms of Restoration drama आर द हीरोइक प्ले एंड द कॉमेडी ऑफ मैनर्स. इट वॉज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाई फ्रेंच फिक्शन एंड फ्रेंच ड्रामा. No account of the restoration period will be complete without notice being taken of its contribution to the development of the drama. Its most important contribution was the comedy of manners. The comedy of manners was in one sense a contribution of the narrative tradition and was influenced by the example of Beaumont and Fletcher and Blaine Johnson. But it was also influenced by Molière, the French dramatist. In respect of ideas for plots and comic characterization, it also borrowed from the Spanish drama, especially that of Calderon, a love of intrigue and incident. In the field of comedy, the Restoration dramatists headed by Etherege and Congreve gave birth to comedy of manners, reflecting the gaiety, foppery, insolence, and intrigue of aristocratic group, which political changes had suddenly brought into prominence and authority. The new comedy is so called because it has a grace of refined culture. It is full of vigor and vitality. The Elizabethan love of emotion is replaced by intellectual control and wit, and their love of poetry by a clear, concise prose which gives a precision and brilliance to the dialogue. The characters are largely types. The writers based their plots on amorous intrigue and flouted the ordinary norms of morality, sometimes, as in the case of Wycherley, indulging in sensuality. For this reason, they were attacked by immorality and licentiousness. But except for the comedies of Wycherley, their work is not offensive because it is intellectual and witty. We should not blame the writers because their comedies are a realistic description of the dissolute courtly life of the period. William Congreve and others. William Congreve is the most precious gem. In his hands, this genre reaches perfection. In his comedies, particularly The Way of the World, his masterpiece, he faithfully reflects the upper class life of his day. His tone is lively and the characters are well drawn. His prose is lucid, concise and pointed. His dialogue are brilliant. He is a polished artist. Love in Wood is one of the four plays written by William Wycherley, whose plays have been called manly, perhaps because of their sensuality and indecency. George Ether's play, including the comical Revenge or Love in a Tub, are important because they established this genre before it was perfected by Congreve. His plays reflect the graceless, heartless and licentious upper classes of the time. Dryden too wrote comedies, including The Wild Gallant, but they are a class apart from the comedy of manners because they are marred by an undercurrent of sentimentalism. The two other practitioners of the comedy of manners who wrote towards the end of the century are Sir John Vanbrugh and George Farquhar, Farquhar. The tradition of Blaine Johnson's comedy of humors was continued by many minor dramatists, including Thomas Shadwell, and the chief exponent of comedy of intrigue was Mrs. Abra Ben. William Congreve's famous comedy, The Way of the World, 1700, is the supreme example of comedy of manners. His first comedy, The Old Bachelor, 1693, brought him fame. His other comedies include The Double Dealer, 1694, and The Love for Love, 1695. In these plays, Congreve shows himself the supreme master of the artificial comedy or comedy of manners, displaying the narrow world of fashion and gallantry. But because of the failure of The Way of the World, Congreve abandoned the theatre and spent the rest of his life in a desultory pursuit of the muses. In Congreve's play, it is the language above all else which enchants the reader. It is a deliberately artificial, subtle, rhythmic, beautifully balanced. In the whole of the English comedy, there is nothing to rival the wit and grace of scenes between Mirabel and Millamant. William Wycherley, 1640-1716, wrote four plays. His first play, Love in a Wood or St. James Park, in 1672, is a comedy of intrigue. His second play, The Gentleman Dancing Master, in 1672. The Country Wife in 1673 and his last play The Plain Dealer in 1674. Lamb classes him with Congreve as one of the best masters of artificial comedy. Wycherley was labeled by Macaulay as licentious and indecent. Then another important dramatist of the period is George Farquhar. He was born 1678 and died in 1707, who wrote 8 plays. He produced Love and a Bottle, The Constant Couple or A Trip to the Jubilee, then Sir Henry Verdier, and then The Constant, then The Twin Rivals, and then The Stagecoach in 1704, then Recurring Officer and Bewick's Straight Gem in 1707. The last two are the best of his plays and are marked by the atmosphere of reality and genial merriment, very different from that of artificial comedy of the period. The Bewick's Stratagem is termed as the realistic comedy. Farquhar died during the third performance of the Bewick's Stratagem. He died in poverty. He wrote it knowing that he was a dying man. Yet no comedy could be more gay and good-humored. He is the most human of the Restoration plays, the only one of them who never inveighs against mankind in spite of the fact that his life was gogged by the poverty and misfortune. Unlike Congreve and Wycherley and the rest, he was not a writer but the son of a poor clergyman. So this is all about the comedy of manners. Thanks a lot for watching the video. If you liked the video, please subscribe the channel and share the video so that others can take benefit of this video. Thanks a lot for watching the video.